Hey everyone, it's Ryan and Paul from Resell CMY. If you're new to us or new to any of our videos, we also do a TikTok as well. Paul does. We buy stuff, typically large collections, and then some stuff at like garage sales and stuff like that. And we turn around and sell that same stuff on eBay, try to make a profit. Yesterday we made a profit for sure. We had an excellent day for us. 23 orders going out for $2,400, $2,403.62 to be exact. A couple of really big items here. A couple of $500 things, I believe, right?
Yeah, a couple of $500.
Is it a couple?
One's 565, one's 500.
Yeah, so we had
225.
Yeah, we had some big numbers going out.
A lot of good, solid sales. I mean, little sales in between, but a lot of big number sales, like $100 here, 50, 80, like that adds up fast.
There's going to be a lot of train stuff because that's what Paul's been listing. But there's some older stuff here too. We'll just hop right into it.
Yeah, guys, a little more on that. We started out garage selling. Like that's how this all started. And then it evolved into us buying collections almost immediately.
Yeah,
because this is where money is.
You're like, seeking bigger and bigger deals.
You always have inventory to sell. And looking.
And nowadays, you go garage sale, you're spending a lot of money just driving.
Yeah.
You know, so we try to factor that into our buys as well. So like when we go out to Rochester, we factor in an extra $100 in gas. Yeah. And then even the one down in, was it Ithaca, yeah. Cortland area or whatever, we had to factor in another 50, 60 bucks in gas for that one too. But yeah, I love buying collections way better.
Oh, way better. Garage selling's fun. It's fun on a Friday. Yeah. It's something to do on a Friday just to split up the monotony of listing and shipping. But buying collections is solidly where the money's at in inventory, and you have stuff to list.
No, and you just gotta hunt them. And I would say next year when we have the shop completely done, we're going to have to schedule it where we kind of do like a 2-3 hour breather on Fridays and just do a little bit of garage sales to kind of mix up the videos and mix up what we're doing, because we just kind of sit in one spot and list nonstop.
Slam out.
Other than the occasional day where we do a big buy,
we're
just listing and listing and listing. So, but yeah, so we'll start it off with a giant sale. This came from the $1,150 games buy. Wheel of Fortune NES game, $8.49 free shipping, so we'll just make like $3-4 on this. Nice. I list some stuff that I think is going to be like 10 and over with free shipping, and then slowly it just gets cheaper and cheaper.
And
it's already listed, so I would never list one that was $8.50 free shipping. Minimum 10, 12.
Next one was a pretty good sale here. These are Walders. These are 85-foot Metro North Horizon commuter coaches. As you can see in there, they're all new. Person wanted all three of them. As you can see here, I have three. I forgot what they were. 80 bucks a piece? What did we have these at? I don't know. They wanted a discount. Offered us $225 plus shipping for all three, and we took it immediately.
Can't even remember.
So $225 you see for those. This one's you.
That started a great day. And then Paul started listing, and this is one of the first ones you listed yesterday, right? So we got another Walters here. 932-26224, 75-foot auto train, auto carrier. It's a two-pack here. I know nothing about these because Paul's been listing them. So
you haven't touched one.
I haven't touched any besides maybe occasional one to tell you guys about. This one sold almost immediately for $125 plus shipping. So whenever something sells immediately, you always think Paul underpriced it. Not, I priced it just right when it sells quickly, though.
And when you see the games are on sale going off, you know Ryan overpriced it.
Yeah, exactly.
You got a good one.
Yeah, you got the big one.
All right, guys, this is a lot of three rare sealed Indiana Jones with the modern marks. I forgot what years they are. Two of these are pretty rare. One of them wasn't at all, but we just lotted them all together, as you can see them here. I don't want to mess with the plastic covers at all. But these went out $500 on auction, one bid plus shipping, and they paid yesterday. So $500 for three VHS.
And honestly, we lotted them up at auction, and we might have been able to pull some more money out, at least from two of them doing individually. But I thought maybe they'd get bid up. But the same buyer that bought that bought the sealed Indiana Jones trilogy a few days ago.
Oh, really?
Nice. Yeah, same buyer. So thank you very much if you watch these videos. Another big dinger.
Yeah, you
this one, not only did I price this one kind of weird, I also screwed up on the shipping because I always, almost always do free shipping on video games. This is Shrek 2 for the Nintendo GameCube, missing the manual. $8.49 again, but this one was plus shipping. And I'd almost guarantee that if I look in the description, it says free shipping. So eventually it got cheap enough where it still made sense with the shipping.
All right.
That's in that black box, yeah.
All right, guys, this is a HO. This is a Bowser Assembled Pennsylvania Railroad. This is a 280. This one's four parts not working, and this one sold $40 on auction plus shipping.
Is that one you listed yesterday?
No. This is auction.
A while ago?
Yeah.
Oh, that was the auction one.
Yeah, the $40.
Is that the one they helped you figure out what it is?
Yep, Bowser.
So what'd you use for that?
I use a Facebook group. Yeah, I just posted a picture, but they told me exactly what it was immediately.
Yeah.
Sold it.
Use those groups. I would never do that because I'm pretty...
Anti-group.
Yeah, anti-group. Waterford Crystal, as you can see. This is a Penrose vase. We have two that are identical to this with the clean box and everything. And then one had a pretty disgusting box, so we're waiting to list that separately. This one, though, sold for $50 plus shipping. I have a note on here, switch address. So this is being purchased as a gift, and they forgot to change the address. So I do that to kind of do a little reminder so I don't screw something up and then blame it on Paul.
This next one sold rather quickly, too. I may have underpriced it. I couldn't find any comps for it. This is the Walther's Amtrak 1700 series baggage car, but this one's actually undecorated. It's all gray. There's nothing on it. This one sold $40 plus shipping.
Okay, this is the third one of these to go out. It's a 30-card set of Nolan Ryan Pacific, 1993. $8 free shipping on this. And the only reason this kind of got lower in price as well, I believe these were $10 free shipping.
Yep.
And then got on sale and then got an offer. But the reason they were listed, because we have like 15 to 20 of them. So we'll make like $4 on this, and it was a single listing, and then it'll just keep happening. Easy shipper.
I'll skip those two. I'm going to go to trains. I'll let you get those two next. Next one here, this is it right here. This is the Long Island Express. This one is a Walther's. It's number 932-5873. It's a dining dash baggage car. This one sold $40 plus shipping.
Okay, we got Skylanders Tech Trap right here. Trap Team Tech Trap. It's brand new sealed, $14 free shipping, super light, make like 10 on this. Man, I'm getting the heavy hitters today.
Yeah, good one too. This next one here, this is a New York Central system. This is just a broken up engine with no parts in it, wires hanging out the back. I said four parts or repair. This one sold $8 plus shipping.
Okay, you got two Nintendo Wii, but they're made by Rock Candy. They're the Nintendo Wii controllers. They're also from that $1,150 games buy. We have a huge tote that I still got to go through, controllers and cables and everything. This is just two like things that I pulled out, lotted them up together. $8.50 plus shipping. Continuing my trend of the heavy hitters today.
And this next one is a Hobby Line. This is Liviona and Wayland. It's a diesel switcher. I wrote it's untested. I don't know if it works. This one sold $18 plus shipping.
I'm going to let you get the next train there, too. I think it's the 60
train here.
Okay, we got Waterpik. Water Flosser is model something. I forgot what it was. I don't know. You could probably see it on the thing. WP-562CD, brand new sealed, $45 plus shipping on this one.
And this next one here is another Walther's. This is a Penn Central Leonard Calvert. This is a club car. This one actually sold $60 plus shipping. I don't know how much is in train stuff right there, but I think it's $500. We spent $500 on listing.
Well, let's add 10 to it right here. Got a little HO scale here. Lifelike. It says coating chemicals, Union Carbide on the side. Just a little HO car. $10 plus shipping on this one.
This next one here is, this was at auction. I have them all boxed up. I'm gonna send them in this box. They're all in there solid. It says fragile on it. You'll see it in the screenshot here. There are a lot of 8 HO scale tanker cars. They're all by Hooker, by Monsiato, Stanley, Thermal Green, all that. They sold on auction $42 plus shipping. Pretty cool to get rid of those.
Help me with this this one. Like, I'm going to click on the bottom one of this.
Mm-hmm.
You click on the next one, and then we'll...
I'll click on the top and work down to you.
Okay, then we'll leapfrog like that or whatever, so I can kind of... So this next deal I worked out last night, it's kind of a funny story. I was going to send offers. I was getting ready for bed, and a bunch of these AFX cards kept popping up in the, you know, the ability to send offers there. And I was sending offers, and when I finished sending offers on all the cars, there was a message of a guy saying, "Hey, if I buy multiple AFX cars, will you do a deal?" And then almost as I'm reading that, he sent another message. "Oh, thanks." And I wrote it back. I'm like, "Hey, I was just sending you offers of the same thing you were sending the message. I didn't even read it yet." One of them he said was still a little bit cheap or a little bit too expensive for his taste. And I said, "Hey, if you buy multiple, I'll knock another $15 off." So you're going to see in the screenshot $575 as the total for these. It's actually $560. The first car here is a 1955 Porsche 934 Turbo. This is the one I'm knocking another $15 off here. So $140 plus shipping.
And this next one here is this 1943. That's the number of it. It's a Ford Street Van. This one sold $65 plus shipping.
I think this is this the Dodge Stacker? No, it's a BMW. The next one here is this Flamethrower number 1952 BMW 320i, yellow and orange, number 3 number. My English this morning is jacked. $110 plus shipping on this one.
Now this next one here is the number 1063-850. This is a Dodge stock car, number 11, unpunched. This one actually sold $130 plus shipping.
Yep, and this is a number 1934-850 Vega funny car. And this one sold for $115 plus shipping. Like I said, these are all from
78.
This one might be a little bit newer, right? Or maybe even older. Yeah, 81 on this one. They're all brand new, sealed, carded. All of them are unpunched, too. And like I said, the total... It's going to be $560 after I refund them the $50.
Another
so thank
cool
you very
story
much.
On these is we've had two of these carded slot car buys.
Same dude.
Same person twice. We bought them. Three of these cars that you've seen go out were from the previous sale, the last three that we had. So only two of the new ones went out, which is awesome for us to get rid of three old dead stock cars and two new ones. So
Andy was
cool.
A repeat buyer. He said that he purchased from us previously, too. So he must have been happy with it. So that's always good.
You got the movie. You're on it.
This one.
And this movie's A Sword in the Stone. This is the one with the sword in the stone and not out of it. This isn't the rare one, but this one sold $12 free shipping.
So we got a Seiko watch going out.
That was cool this morning.
Yeah. This is a nice one. I checked already to make sure the battery is still good. We had all the batteries replaced on these, but I always check. It says a unique secondhand. It's that little circle down there.
Oh, yeah.
And it just slowly ticks. But yeah, this was like a gold banded one. The number on this one is SED002, I believe.
Do we have any more of those or no?
This is the one that has that stretchy band.
Okay.
And the one that didn't work, so we have to relist it as for parts one. Okay. But in new working order, because none of these were ever used. So for $195.50 plus shipping on this one. So that was an awesome
overseas
sale.
Overseas, too. They paid a lot to get it shipped. I looked, it was like $270 total. When
total
it came
all
through.
In.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
And this next sale here is this came from Dana. This is Stephen King, The Dark Tower. This is the trilogy, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 books here together. We had them listed for $50. I sent out an offer for $42.22 because that's how I like to do it. They sent a counter offer back for $32.22 to Ryan. He immediately accepted it. Just to have room on the bookshelf, because everything from Dana is now profit anyways. But these went out $32.22 plus shipping.
And part of the reason, though, I accepted it is because I had no idea where your first offer was.
$42.
So I don't want to come back at... I've actually come back at higher than Paul's previous offer before because I didn't know. So I'm like, just sell it. It's a lot of room on the bookshelf for more sealed media. So the last thing that sold were these 1990 McDonald's McDinos. There's 8 of them in here. And these were being sold as lots of two. We actually had a lot go out yesterday. And as I was going through, some of the packaging was pretty bad. So I just pulled them out of the drawer, ended the listing. Paul relisted it as a lot, and it sold within a day. I took pictures
of the dirty ones up close and personal, so they all
know. Yeah, so $22 free shipping on this, though. So. The dogs are whining. Come on. No, that was my dog. Come here. What's the matter?
But that's it.
Yeah, that's a fantastic day. So I got to remember to combine some shipping on a couple things. I have to remember to change the address. And I have a video posting at 10 today, too. So this is good. I can just edit this one.
That's a damn good Thursday, $2,400. Probably like $2,100.
We needed it because was a day or two where we snuck it by. It was like $200 or $190.
$400.
That's what happens, though, because Paul had all that medical stuff going on.
As soon as you don't list, you take a few days off, that shit slows right down.
And beginning of September is a weird time on eBay always. Yeah. Back to school stuff, getting ready to pay taxes, school taxes, just getting ready for hunting season, changing of the seasons, closing pools. There's so many things going on. I think a lot of people drop off.
After hunting season, Ryan and I really kind of slow down hunt season. Maybe not as much this year. Try to hunt a few times. I obviously get out there. I'm not going to not hunt. But after you see hunting season in the winter, this really picks up. That's when January, February, March just really
goes hard. Yeah, a lot of people on eBay, quarter four is what they rely on.
Yeah.
We slow down. Right down.
Slow down.
We might do decent this year, though, because we got the building going up.
Yeah.
I need to...
We have to make money, so it's not like we just...
Yeah, I got to save up enough money so I have some room here so I can do all the spray foam and the concrete slab next spring. So that's going to be like another $30,000.
We're in it for quarter one every year.
Yeah, quarter one.
Every year.
January through like March is my favorite time.
Yeah, because we ain't doing nothing but listing in a house, hiding from snow, and it's cold.
Yeah.
So you just list.
And hunting's over. Yeah. You've been outside so much that you don't mind being inside. But thanks for watching up to this point, you guys. Please comment, like, and subscribe. And leave a nice comment for Kennedy, Paul's daughter, because she's going to end the video for us.
All right, see you guys.
Say resell CNY.
Resell CNY.
Said, please like and subscribe.
Please like and subscribe.
Say thank you.
Thank you.
And bye.
Bye.
Bye, guys. Thank you.
Bye.